Now that we've inserted the IV, let's look at how we attach the extension tubing, or if you remember, the pigtail. So attach the primed extension tubing to the catheter hub. We're going to apply our transparent dressing without obstructing the view of the insertion site. This is really important. We need to see where that catheter went in. Now slowly draw back on the plunger of the attached saline flush to aspirate or pull back and see if we have blood return. This is going to let us know if we were successfully in the vein or not. Now, after visualizing blood return, slowly inject the saline flush into the extension tubing and through the catheter. Now clamp the catheter and remove the saline flush. So, when we're doing this, if we can, avoid as much as possible that insertion site. Main thing is that we have this stabilized, and now we can put on our transparent device. Excuse me, our transparent dressing. The reason why I'm doing this, I want to cover this as quickly as possible and hold that catheter steady so it doesn't budge out of that vein. Now, because I've got soil gloves, I'm going to remove these quickly and throw these in the trash. All right, so you notice this person's arm's a little bit messy. That is okay. So we were clean, and we can clean this up later. All right, so now that the transparent's dressing on, this is why I do this, so that way this is stabilized and I can pull back on this plunger slightly. The reason why I'm doing this is you see there's blood flow and I've got flash or blood return when I'm assessing to make sure I'm in the vein. And clearly, as you saw earlier, we're definitely in the vein. So I'm going to push this slowly. And you see how that clears up. There's the saline that's in there. That means we're definitely good. When I flush the vein, I see there's no blebbing. Also, I was going to ask you, did you have any pain when I flushed?
Nope.
Okay, great. So we want to make sure that's not blebbing, leaking at the site. It's not painful for our patient. So this is nice and flushed. So now what I'm going to do is clamp this. So this is why, if you noticed, why I kept the plunger attached. That way I'm not trying to finagle this later when I'm trying to hold pressure. So because our patient has such nice veins, I was in a good one, it got a little bit messy, obviously, but that's okay because we can definitely clean all of this up later, make this look nice and pretty. But now that I've got this, I can untake this off. Keep this nice and down. So here's a transparent dressing. So here's the difference from facility to facility. Some facilities put a stabilization device underneath there. Now, a lot of the times, a lot of facilities do not do that or put or allow tape underneath a transparent dressing because that's another microbe attacher or attractor or something like that to get under there. Now that we've attached the extension tubing, now we need to protect that IV site we just put in. So we're going to place the extension tubing in a desired location and make sure to tape that down securely in place. Then we need to label the dressing with date, time, initials, and the catheter size that we just used. Okay, so now that we've just finished up inserting the IV, so now I've cleaned up the patient. So earlier, notice there can be some blood, a little bit of that when you're inserting the IV. So notice that when I did that, I kept my cool, made sure I kept the insertion of the IV in the catheter, and then make sure I promptly added the extension tubing. You don't want to lose your IV site, so therefore stay calm if that happens, secure your IV, and then make sure you clean up your patient for comfort, and just to make sure there's not any additional tape or anything like that, or blood that can add for microbes and cause infection. So now that we've got this all taped down, I'm going to secure this much better just because anytime this is in a patient arm, this can get tugged, it can move around. So there's lots of different ways you can tape. I'm going to show you how I do that. Okay, one thing also to keep in mind about tape. Notice under the transparent dressing, unless your facility says they use a stabilization device, we should not do this tape method underneath that. We want to keep everything clean and sterile underneath the transparent dressing. So let me show you what I do. This tape is very nicely torn, so I'm going to do a nice little generous piece of tape here. And if you take the middle of this, it very easily splits, which is really nice for you. And you can even save this tape and put it on the back of your glove. So notice how much thinner that is, which is nice. And I'm going to slide this underneath the extension tubing. So notice my IV is already in, my insertion site's covered, nothing under is underneath that transparent. And then I'm going to crisscross this tape here. So I'm just going to cross this here and cross this here. Then I'm going to take an additional piece of tape, and then I can put this around where the catheter attaches, and this will just help stabilize that as well. So if you notice and I tug on this a little bit, it's much more secure for the patient. All right, now we also have our extension tubing, and so this isn't draping around. We're going to secure this in place with our for a patient too. I love this tape, very easy to tear. Now, one more thing to consider. When you're inserting an IV, some patients are allergic to adhesive. So if that's the case, there's alternatives that you can use. So I'm just gonna make a nice little loop, and I'm going to secure this down for my patient so it's not dragging all over the place for him when he moves his arm. Also, don't forget, now every little piece of transparent dressing has a little label, and it makes you remind you to put your initials, the date, and what size, or we call it the gauge of the catheter is.